Hello, everyone. In this video, we'll look at the patent databases available on Dialog. Whether you're a patent professional doing a prior art search or checking the legal status of a patent, or if you're researching the state of the art in any area of technology, or if you're searching for intellectual property as part of an assets check or a company profile, Dialog has an excellent collection of patent databases to suit your needs. We'll show you how to access our patent databases, followed by an overview of the whole set of 40 patent databases on Dialog. Then we'll look at some of the most frequently used patent databases in a bit more detail to explain the coverage of each one, along with their strengths and possible limitations to help you make the most effective database selections for your patent search. So let's get started. When you're logged into Dialog in the basic search mode, you should see an icon for patents as one of the standard database collections. By clicking here, you'll be taken into all 40 of the patent databases. In the alternative, if you click here on the total number of databases, you'll get a drop-down list of databases organized by two tabs, one for the general or non-patent databases, the other for the patent databases. Click on that tab, and you'll see a list of all 40 patent databases, which you can select all at once, or individually using the checkboxes. So let's move on to look at the patent databases on ProQuest Dialog. There are 40 of them, as I mentioned. Some are kind of all-purpose or family-based, like INPADOC and Derwent. Some focus on just one country, like the Fulltext databases. And some have very special purposes. Derwent Patent Citations Index, for example, is especially for finding which older patents or which articles were cited either by the applicant or the examiner when a particular patent was applied for. Or you may want to know which patents came along later where the applicant cited that patent in a new application. Those are sometimes called backward and forward citations. And you can do that kind of search in INPADOC or in some other databases, but Derwent Patent Citations Index is specially designed for this. There's LitAlert, which is the only database where you can find out if any lawsuits have been filed in the U.S. federal courts concerning any U.S. patents. U.S. trademark lawsuits are also covered here. And IMS Patents Focus is a great database if you're searching for information about pharmaceutical patents. It lets you look them up by the trademark or generic names, for example, which is the kind of information not found in the actual patents, as well as detailed info about the status of related drug patents across many countries around the world. The company that makes this database stopped adding to it very recently, but it's still a great resource. And now let's look at some of the more widely used or general purpose databases in a little more depth. Derwent World Patents Index at one time was the single most widely used patent database that we have. It's very good for term searching because it has abstracts that are written by the Derwent people. They're written by specialists and they're written for searchers using the kind of language that a searcher is likely to use in looking for these patents. Their family information is put together manually by these experts so that what you end up with is families that are essentially the same invention, not just related more broadly, but really the same thing. Derwent also has a number of special indexing fields unique to that database. You should be aware, however, that this database does not have legal status information, so this is not the place to look to see if your patent has been reassigned or if it's been marked expired. It also does not have full text. INPADOC has the broadest country coverage of any patent database. It now has about 110 countries that are covered. For about half of those, it has the legal status information as well, which is often quite detailed. The family information can be found in INPADOC two different ways. It gives you what's called the EPO simple families, and that is the group of patents that share all of the same priorities. Those are going to be very, very similar to each other, But INPADOC will also show you a broader version of the complete patent family, where perhaps only one priority application number is shared. This will show you, let's say, not only identical twins and triplets, but also cousins and second cousins, if you really want to get a broad look at a patent family. This database, however, is not optimal for term searching because it doesn't have the full text, and for most countries, it doesn't have the claims. So this is a great database if you're searching by something like company name, or if you're searching by the class numbers, then it's perfect. This database can also be very cost effective because once you've done your search, you can either decide to download all of the patents that you get, or you can reduce it to just one patent for each family by clicking a button. We also have full text patent databases for some 32 countries. And these are very flexible databases because they do have the full text from all kinds of countries in English. So you can do an English language search and get patents from Korea, for example. These databases do very often have the legal status information and they have patent family information. So you can search all kinds of different ways and get all kinds of different information from these databases. Here is a list of the countries. And as you can see, these include not only familiar major patent authorities, but also quite a few countries that we don't think of ordinarily as major patenting authorities. But keep in mind, if your idea for a patent has already come out as a published application in Norway or in Luxembourg, then you have a problem with your prior art search. It doesn't matter that it didn't come out in the US or Great Britain. If it was published in one of these countries, then it's an old idea, and you need to know about that. So these databases are very useful in your prior art searching. For US patents, we actually offer a choice of two full text databases. One is called US Patents Full Text, and it's similar to the databases we just looked at. But we also have a database called IFI Claims. And despite its name, it's not only the claims of a patent, it has the full text of US patents. It also has detailed legal status information, and it lets you search these patents in several ways that just cannot be done in other databases. For example, one of its functions is called probable assignee searching. This has to do with the fact that when published applications first come out, they're very often not in the name of the company. They're in the name of the inventor. So in other databases, you can search for patents for a company and you won't get these records. But in IFI Claims, you will get those hits. You can also limit your searches in IFI Claims by the status of a patent. You can tell the search engine that you want only patents that are active, that haven't been expired yet. Or maybe you just want to get patents that are still in the pipeline. They're at the stage of being published applications, but they're not granted yet. You can limit your results to just those very easily in this database. This database does not have patent family information, but it's otherwise a terrific choice if your concentration is on U.S. patent searching. So that's it. A summary of the 40 patent databases available to you on Dialog. It's truly an excellent set of resources for patent searching of all kinds, and we hope you'll enjoy using these databases on Dialog. If you'd like more information, here are some additional resources. And if you have any questions or need help, you're welcome to call the help desk at these numbers, or you can email us at customer@dialog.com. Thanks for using Dialog, and enjoy the rest of your day.